Hello everyone, I'm Betaria from the English area Fun English. Here we are discussing about the exercise you did previously on listening to part C. Strategi seputar the questions, the topic, and the order of the answers. Sebelum mulai, jangan lupa tekan tombol subscribe. Gratis ya. Dan jangan lupa nyalakan loncengnya. Dapatkan tayangan-tayangan belajar bahasa Inggris bersama di English Area Fun English. Pastikan kalian sudah mengerjakan latihan sebelumnya, Listening Part C. Kita akan segera bahas latihannya. We'll start from Talk 1. This talk is for number 1 through 4. Ingat, sambil menyimak apa yang disampaikan dalam teks, kita dapat menelusuri jawaban-jawaban yang ada di pilihan jawaban. Jangan lupa prediksi pertanyaan seputar what, when, where, who, or how.
Questions 1 through 4. Listen to a description of the Ringling Museum. In a few minutes, we'll be arriving at the Ringling Museum in Sarasota, Florida. This museum was built by John Ringling and his wife Mabel. John Ringling became famous as one of the Ringling Brothers, who formed the Ringling Brothers Circus. We'll be visiting two areas, the Museum of Art and the Circus Gallery. The Museum of Art contains some excellent Baroque paintings, including some by Rubens. The Circus Gallery contains items from circuses of years past, including a 100-year-old circus parade wagon. Enjoy your visit to the Ringling Museum. I'll see you back at the bus in 3 hours.
Number 1. Who is probably talking?
Di sini, kita bisa prediksi pertanyaan dari pilihan jawaban yang tersedia berupa jenis-jenis profesi dan nama orang. Pertanyaan seputar who, siapa? Dari pernyataan kalimat dalam teks, in a few minutes, we'll be arriving at the Ringling Museum in Sarasota, Florida. This museum was built by John Ringling and his wife, Mabel. Dalam beberapa menit, kita akan tiba di Museum Ringling. Museum ini didirikan oleh John Ringling dan istrinya, Mabel. Kita kenali dari konteks ini, biasanya yang berbicara adalah seorang tour guide, pemandu wisata. It's D, a tour guide.
Number 2. Why did John Ringling become famous?
Pilihan jawaban yang tersedia diawali dengan because. Kita prediksi pertanyaannya. Pertanyaannya berupa why, asking for a reason. Why did John Ringling become famous? John Ringling became famous as one of the Ringling Brothers, who formed the Ringling Brothers Circus. Formed, established, began, started. The answer is C, because he started a circus.
Number 3. What is included in the circus gallery?
Sambil menelusuri pilihan jawaban sesuai dengan urutan soal, ada noun phrase di nomor 3. Kemungkinan pertanyaannya seputar what. Kita cek satu persatu. Dalam teks, pilihan jawaban dengan poin yang disebutkan dalam teks. What is included in the circus gallery? Dalam teks disebutkan, the circus gallery contains items from circuses of years past, including a 100-year-old circus parade wagon. Jadi jawabannya adalah C, a parade wagon.
Number 4. What should the people do in 3 hours?
Pilihan jawaban yang tersedia menunjukkan kata kerja, sehingga kemungkinan pertanyaannya seputar kegiatan yang disebutkan di dalam teks. Pernyataan dalam teks menyebutkan, "I'll see you back at the bus in 3 hours." Back means return. What should the people do in 3 hours? Jawabannya adalah see, return to the bus. Kembali ke bus. Oke, langsung kita lanjutkan ya. Let's move to talk 2.
Questions 5 through 8. Listen to a lecture by a business professor.
Henry Ford's Model T automobile is a great example of the benefits of mass production. Henry Ford introduced the Model T in 1908. These first Model T cars weren't mass-produced. They were sold for a price of $850 each. The Model T cars were very popular, and many people wanted to own them. To meet this high demand, Henry Ford designed the first major assembly line. With this assembly line, cars could be produced more quickly, efficiently, and cheaply. Using the assembly line method of production, the company was able to produce 1,000 identical cars a day. The price of the Model T dropped from $850 to $440 per car by 1914. The price dropped even further to $290 per car by 1924. This example clearly demonstrates the effect that mass production can have on prices.
Number 5. What is the Model T?
Dari pilihan jawaban yang tersedia, kita bisa memprediksi bahwa pertanyaannya seputar what. What is the Model T? Dari pernyataan yang ada dalam teks, these first Model T cars weren't mass-produced. The Model T cars were very popular and many people wanted to own them. The Model T cars. It refers to a car. Jawabannya adalah B, a car.
Number 6. When was the Model T introduced?
Pilihan jawaban yang tersedia menunjukkan years, tahun. Jadi kita dengan mudah bisa memprediksi pertanyaannya seputar when. Kapan? When was the Model T introduced? Pernyataan dalam teks menyebutkan Henry Ford introduced the Model T in 1908. So it's the answer is A, in 1908.
Number 7. What was not true about assembly line production by Ford?
Pilihan jawaban yang tersedia menunjukkan deskripsi suatu benda. Oleh karena itu, pertanyaannya seputar what. Apa? What was not true about assembly line production by Ford? Not true berarti yang tidak sesuai dengan teks. Pernyataan teks menyebutkan, with this assembly line, cars could be produced more quickly, efficiently, and cheaply. Quickly, faster. Efficiently, more efficient. Cheaply, cheaper. Jadi yang tidak disebutkan dalam teks adalah C, it was more individualized.
Number 8. What happened to the price of the Model T over time?
So what happened? Pernyataan dalam soal menyebutkan the price of the Model T dropped from $850 to $440 per car by 1914. The price dropped even further to $290 per car by 1924. Kata dropped bersinonim dengan decreased. So the answer is D, it decreased. Last but not least, talk 3. Let's listen to the talk.
Questions 9 through 12. Listen to a talk by a university graduate student advisor.
Hello, I'm Ms. Barker, the graduate advisor in the psychology department. You should all be new graduate students in this department. Because I'm your advisor, we'll be seeing a lot of each other during your studies. Today, I'd like to explain a choice that you have to make about your program in psychology. You must decide how you want to finish your program. At the end of this program, you must do one of two things. Either you must write a thesis, or you must take comprehensive exams. Let me tell you a little bit about each of them. A thesis is a long research paper, perhaps 100 or 200 pages long. It's an in-depth study of one area from your graduate studies. Comprehensive exams are exams that cover all of the material in your graduate program. Basically, you must decide if you want to cover one area in depth in your program, so you would write a thesis, or if you'd like a more general program, so you would take comprehensive exams. You don't need to decide today about the thesis or comprehensive exams. You have 6 months to think about it.
Number 9. Who is Ms. Barker talking to?
Pilihan jawaban yang tersedia menunjukkan profesi, sehingga pertanyaannya seputar who. Who is Ms. Barker talking to? Pernyataan teks menyebutkan, "Hello, I'm Ms. Barker, the graduate advisor in the psychology department. You should all be new graduate students in this department." Jadi jawabannya, C, graduate students in the psychology department.
Number 10. What choice do the students have to make?
Whether biasanya digunakan untuk menunjukkan choice, pilihan. Pernyataan dalam teks menyebutkan, "At the end of this program, you must do one of two things. Either you must write a thesis, or you must take comprehensive exams." Jadi jawabannya, it's A, whether to write a thesis or take an exam.
Number 11. What are comprehensive exams?
Pernyataan dalam teks menyebutkan, "Comprehensive exams are exams that cover all the material in your graduate program." So, it matches with point C, exams covering all material in the program.
Number 12. When do the students need to make the decision?
Pada nomor ini, pilihan jawaban menunjukkan indikator waktu. Prediksi bentuk pertanyaannya adalah when. When do the students need to make the decision? Pernyataan dalam soal menyebutkan, you have 6 months to think about it. 6 months means half a year. So the answer is D, within half a year. That's it for this session. Thanks for watching and learning with Teavan English. See you soon!